play rather well in game number two, but in both of his losses showed some real weaknesses. Whereas Altec, on the other hand, was able to come back from a pretty big deficit in his loss in game two.
Yeah, and I think that the flame horizoning back and forth and all that stuff is just, it's really just been a back and forth thing. That's actually not a Nidalee ban. That is a Cassiopeia ban. Let's come out here. There we go.
Yeah, the karma is correct, though. But as you can see, it has been updated. And entering into Champion Select, Cloud9 Challenger lead the series 2-1. Looks like they are going to ban away Golden Glue in the mid lane. Azir following up that Cassiopeia.
I think the Vlad is the last ban or the first pick here with Sivir. So yeah, there they go.
Yeah, there goes Karma and Malzahar. There's the Sivir ban once again for Piglet. Didn't look quite so comfortable on that Ash, but Rek'Sai banned away from contract.
So Vladimir's still up. Still also have the Twitch available here for Altec. You see, Cloud9 are actually taking a little bit longer here with their first pick than they have in the past. Usually it's just been Shen, go, go, go.
Yeah.
But now with the GP being something that Solo was able to win the lane with, they have to think a little bit more about that and what they really want.
Ooh, Nidalee is the first pick for Cloud9 Challenger contracts, showing, hey, Moon, you can go deathless for a significant portion of the game that's pretty stompy, but let me show you what I can do.
Yeah, and see if it ends up being to great effect here, because Contracts has played a lot of low CC junglers with the Graves, with the Nidalee, but his laners will typically bring the CC for him.
Mm-hmm.
And that allows him to make those plays early on, which is something we weren't seeing on TLA due to the lack of CC.
You can see Golden Glue on your screen right now talking with Piglet and their coach behind them to try to figure out these first two picks. And looks like they're going to steal away Cloud9 Challenger. Twitch for Piglet and Shen for Solo.
That's awesome. If they can play this submarine combo, that's going to throw Cloud9 Challenger for a loop, because the Twitch was previously being banned from TLA. But if they're saying, you know what, I can play Twitch, let's do it. Let's mess these guys up.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think Piglet, I talked about it at the start of the series, Piglet's the type of player that if you punish him, you make him go like 0-7 in lane, then the next game is going to be like, all right, team, we're taking the globals.
Yeah.
Everybody, use them on me. We're going in.
We're taking the carries.
And preventing the enemy team from doing what they had done previously to shut him down, because he loves to carry. It's his style. And he's going to see if he can actually hold up here against Cloud9 Challenger, carry his team with the Twitch.
Well, the pressure is on. We'll see how Team Liquid Academy continue to round out their composition as Contracts locks in Braum for Lemonation and Altec goes back to that Lucian that was so effective in that previous game.
Yeah, and I think that the Twitch versus Lucian matchup, fantastic for Twitch, because it's a survivable lane. It's not as punishing as some other matchups, but it's that Twitch range advantage against the Lucian near the mid and late game where Lucian really can't do anything about it. So you have to find your advantage early as the Lucian, or else you just get pushed out of the game by the Twitch, who just has way more impact in a team fight than you. But the Braum is going to be there to negate a little bit of that impact.
Currently, Taric being looked at. Looks like Team Liquid Academy might be putting all of their eggs in the Protect the Piglet basket.
It's also the Sneaky Stealth basket, because you put your W, your Bastion onto him, and then you can stun from stealth. Like, they can't see it coming.
Sneaky stealth!
Yeah, and then they also have the ultimate coming through.
Sneaky,
and that's gonna be, despite the Splash Art being the new rise, that is the old rise being locked in for Golden Glue.
Yeah. Still the 613 rise. Does have the Desperate Power ultimate. Not quite the portal.
Yeah, glad that our guys are on top of it, though.
Yep. Already getting ready for that next 614 coming in out to the LCS in a few days. But in this game,
Europe tomorrow.
Oh, you're correct. I'm sorry, I don't think of Europe when I think of competitive regions. It goes straight to NALCS,
whoa.
And LCK, and LPL. But NA Challenger Series going on right now. Cloud9 Challenger, they're going to be the ones who take that Gnar into the Shen.
Yep, great matchup for him.
And Victor locked in for high.
Yep, Victor up against the Ryze. It's really what you have left now with the three mid lane bans, the Kennen being disabled. guess you could go Cassiopeia. You could go Vladimir here, but it's not the greatest. And he wants that wave clear because they were having a wave clear problem in the last game. And it's a moon special.
Ooh.
We talked about going in on stealth. Again, another stealth champion here for TLA.
Yeah.
They are pulling out all the stops right now. And it just looks like TLA are saying, all right, we're changing the whole face of this series. If this goes to five, you're really going to have to think about this game.
Oh, yeah.
What you're banning next.
The B-52 composition out of TLA. Double stealth and some submarines to go with it. Team Liquid Academy looking to bring us to game number five. This is going to be a very exciting match if TLA can pull this off.
And Evelyn was always a special champion for Moon. It's a champion that he had always found success on. Sometimes he'll build full AP and take over the game. I actually think that it's his most aggressive champion and his most comfortable champion as well. When we saw him in the LCS, he had some of the worst early game jungler stats in the entire league, if not the worst. But his Evelynn is a different story.
Yeah, definitely a very commanding champion for him. But the bans are the games are about to go live. So weigh in on Twitter. Use at LOL Esports. Slap on the hashtag C9CWin or hashtag TLAWin. Is Team Liquid Academy going to bring us to that ace match, to that game five, or will Cloud9 Challenger close this series out once and for all with this final game?
Yeah, and take the championship and being the North American Challenger Series champions, as well as having that first round that they don't have to play in the elimination match and are immediately seeded into the double elim portion of the bracket, mm-hmm. which is very, very important because at that point, there are four teams in, and three of them make it out. So you have a high likelihood that you end up making it to the LCS there. I guess more often than not, you will.
Yeah.
Depending on like everything is even.
It's five teams, right? The three lower three and then the two challenger.
Yes, five go in.
And three come out.
No, five go in, but if you make it to the double elim
portion
first.
That's correct.
Exactly.
From double.
One team's already been eliminated off of that match, that loser of this place versus the last place LCS team.
Yeah, and you definitely want that momentum going forward. I mean, Cloud9 Challenger, if they're able to take convincing wins like they did in game number one and game number three, they're definitely going to be looking to do it once again if they can make it towards that single best of five. Whereas Team Liquid Academy looking to even it right back up and show that they're the ones who deserve that double elim portion of the bracket.
Yeah, if they don't prove it here, then they have to prove it against the 10th place team, and then they have to prove it against the 8th place team. So that route, much harder. So they're just fighting for an easier route through the Challenger Series promotion tournament to the LCS.
However, seems like we have loaded onto the Rift. Lemonation walking over Ward to look for some vision on that Gromp. He will be able to see if there is going to be a start on that. We've had a lane swap. We've had standard lanes. We've had Australian. And everything in between. Question is, what is going to be the start to this one? Looks like we're seeing another lane swap as Stunt and Piglet head towards the top side of the map.
So I have a theory that this game, once the lanes are completely broken up, I think that TLA wants a lane swap. Because first off, Shen versus Gnar, bad matchup.
Yep.
Second off, you do way better with stealth champions when the lanes are long. Because you can flank them. Doesn't matter if they have wards like their red buff or anything.
Mm.
You can walk right past those things and just get behind them in the lane and flank them. Then you have the Shen also ultimate on you. So at TLA, I think it's very crucial that they get this lane swap off. They get those turrets so that they can actually open up the map.
Yeah, Team Liquid Academy are spotted on a ward now on that top side of the map. They're going to try to steal away the small sentinels from this blue buff, while Stunt will chase onto Contracts, manages to land a stun and get some good damage, but that's a Nidalee. She'll be able to jungle just fine without...
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, steals the small Direwolf.
Stunt played that really well. And so his aggressive invade on the Taric ends up being quite profitable for him, and that's going to put them slightly behind because you don't have a level 2 coming in there. But they wouldn't have had that anyway because it looked as though Balls took one of the CS.
Yeah, Moon and Solo, they did the same thing starting with the Direwolf on their side of the map. They don't suffer any disruption from Lemonation, however. So we are seeing pretty much mirrored jungle starts on opposite sides as the lane swap looks to break down those early tier 1 turrets.
Yep, open up the map, get those tier ones down, especially since TLA also is running double teleport, and I guess triple global in a way. So they're running triple global versus one global on Cloud9 Challenger. And I feel like this is going to be just a fantastic composition for Piglet. And Cloud9 Challenger, they have to assume that the pressure is going to be on that bottom lane, that they're going to try to shut down Alltech and Lumination after the performance they had last game.
Yeah.
And roam early and often.
Well, the pressure is on to see if they can do that, to take down those turrets and look for those advantages. And as you can see, we do have a pause on screen. We're going to try to figure that as quickly as possible.
Yeah, but looks like Piglet.
Cloud9 Challenger looking for a nice slow start to this one. Not going to slowball it quite so quickly. Don't have as explosive potential.
It's mostly reliant on just that bottom lane. They have Illusion and Braum, and that's kind of the double whammy here, is that lane wants to play forward. They want to play aggressive and punish you and get an advantage, especially over somebody like a Twitch. But as soon as you do that, everybody on TLA is going to arrive. So then it becomes about surviving that damage until you get to the point where you are able to turn it back around and have everybody arrive despite not having global.
Yeah, well, taking a look at the team comp, you can also see there's a lot of potential to nuke a Twitch if you can find him.
Yeah, if you can find him. They have an exhaust, and they also have an ignite, so it's not double exhaust here or even TP for high. So I definitely give that advantage in the mid lane to Golden Glue because he can just shove them out, but it is going to be that victor. You have to worry about the damage because he's, I think, that main source of the nuke is just that backline access. If he can get an ultimate and an E onto the Twitch, then it really makes a very different team fight for all of Cloud9 Challenger.
Yeah, putting all those eggs in the Twitch basket. They do have the support of Golden Glue on that rise, very capable of scaling and carrying. And he's done it before. We've seen him on these late game hyper carries like Cassiopeia and Azir. Well, this time he's got rise, which is pretty close.
Yeah, it's pretty close. He ends up having a little bit harder time in these fights to affect people in an AoE sense, but this is still the rise that has the perma route, or I guess the four chain route,
yeah,
so that he's able to keep going back and back and back, or back keep stopping people from going back,
yeah,
and rooting them over and over and over again.
As you can see, Piglet on your screen, he is the reason that we've got the pause right now, having a few audio issues with his headset. We're going to try to get that sorted out as quickly as possible as we get ready to get back into this. Definitely going to need that audio in order to keep yourselves alive as Cloud9 Challenger and Team Liquid Academy looking to bring us to that game five. Whereas Cloud9 Challenger hoping to close it out right here and right now. Certainly will be difficult to make that happen, as there's no way Team Liquid Academy are just going to roll over. Even in the game that we just had with Game 3, the fact that Team Liquid Academy were down 15 kills, 10,000 gold, and then they still, we've got late game.
Oh, yeah.
We've got the scaling composition. We can wait it out.
I feel like they don't want to wait this one out, though, too long. I feel like you want to have early aggressive moves with Moon. You can have them with Piglet and Stunt after the lane swap, but they do have great scaling here with the rise and with the Twitch. I definitely think they outscale on the side of TLA right now, and they can have better early game pressure if they play it correctly, but that's up to Moon.
Yeah, in case of emergencies, they do have that. There is a lot of weight on to Moon to make that happen. As you can see, the tier ones are being traded. Looks like right now, Cloud9 Challenger just a little bit ahead. It is rather even, though. Taking a look in the mid lane, lasers being tossed left and right. Contract secures blue buff for himself. And Moon will do the same on that opposite side of the map. So Golden Glue not going to have too much trouble catching these minions in the mid lane. Ooh, there he goes. Snares that one to secure it. And should be able to get that one as well. So keeps pace with High despite that early aggression. High actually on the roam, helping out get a few wards on this side of the jungle for the eventual swap back now that those tier 1 turrets have been taken.
I'm interested to see what Moon does here, because he can just go for a standard jungle route, ends up getting all of that. But I mean, it's Evelynn, so he could actually have a cheeky play here where Alltech walks up, but you have TP from Golden Glue, but you also would have the Evelynn be able to walk up too, completely undetected.
Double gank.
Yeah, there's some cute plays that you can make with Evelynn just because she's so different and she just avoids all of your wards.
keeping an eye on Moon. Looks like he did go for the challenging smite first with that Skirmisher's Saber. No boots just yet. And Contrax only just now completing his recall. Decides to go for the Warden Smite.
Yeah, goes for the Tracker's Knife here, but picks up an Amp Tome as opposed to the Hunter's Potion. Hunter's Potion does make a lot of sense on Evelyn since her clear is so bad. But I did notice that Moon had Thunderlord's Decree, so I assume it's going to be a full damage Evelyn here, or at least one that just tries to get off the ground by using Ravage and Q and just trying to blow somebody up or make sure that they take a large amount of damage.
There is a lot of escape for Cloud9 Challenger. Taking a look at the lanes, Lucian who can dash back, Braum who can leap to someone, and Gnar who can bounce away. So we're going to have to make sure that these ganks count for Moon as the double turret trade begins. And Team Liquid Academy secure the bottom tier 1 turret.
Yeah, they start moving towards the Infernal Drake. They've already started it up. They're trying to take that as their prize here. It looks like Contrax and Lemonation are both going to try to get in this area. Try to contest.
Yeah, they're trying to fight over this.
Oh, we might see a team fight here.
And turret finally will fall. There's going to be a stun onto Contrax. He flashes the wall, though, getting poisoned out. Teleport now being completed as Balls gets in, but the Infernal Drake has been secured. And Team Liquid Academy get it and get out.
Oh, Golden Glue almost dies in the mid lane because he had Altec diving him using both summoner spells. Oh, boy. Very intense fight right there, but nobody ends up going down. He's really split, too.
That's going to be the advantage for Team Liquid Academy early on, as they're able to secure that first Drake for themselves. And despite that initial excitement, seems like we're going to see a reset as Piglet heads down to the bottom lane, but and Altec and Lemonation do the same.
But this is where we're going to start seeing more and more action. When the level 6 comes out for Shen, but also we're seeing them go back to the 2-on-2 after everything's been opened up here. So Twitch will be able to thrive, Evelyn will be able to thrive as well, and as soon as you have that that ultimate, the Stand United, then Shen can really make Twitch just an absolute monster, and you have to think differently when approaching this composition from TLA. Playing against it is not easy. Because you can't overthink it and be like, Evelyn could be here, so I'm not going to do this. Because he just gets extra pressure.
Moon, though, on the invade, finds Contrax and gets a ward over to that Gromp. Meanwhile, Altec will trade some damage on the stunt as the duo on the opposite side continues to farm it out nice and patiently. Moon actually shows himself and is escorting this minion wave in, trying to prevent the freeze setup.
Yeah, that's a... It's actually the right move here. It just so happens that Contrax is on this side of the map as well. But that means that they get it all the way to the turret. They stop the freeze from happening, which is the best scenario for Cloud9 Challenge, for TLA right now. Just prevent that from happening.
Deny as much as you can. I feel like it's sort of the Pirate's Code. Take what you can, give nothing back.
Thought it was a parlay.
Parsley.
Oh my god.
There are more guidelines, really.
It's true. Anyway, TLA.
So there's no honor among thieves. Is there honor among pirates?
Only if you're a bad one.
Wait, if you're a bad pirate? As in, like, evil or just not a good?
Like, as in a bad one, as in not a good one.
Not great?
Yeah, this is bad because it's not good, pirate. And that's why it's bad.
An honorable pirate.
It's funny because everything can just go the other way. It's
exactly.
Like, yeah, I say bad because it's not good.
Oh, man. The double meanings.
An awful pirate.
Yes. He's not a great pirate.
He's not good at his job, which I don't even know if I'd call it a job. His occupation.
Not very talented at piracy. Well, actually, he could be talented at it.
He could
be. He's not good, yeah.
He's just not very smart. Regardless, pirates aside, there are none in this game. No gangplank. Opted for the Shen instead, which is close to hitting that level 6. And that's where I feel as though they're going to start abusing this here. It's the first time that TLA have actually invested in the Shen.
Ooh, they're chasing. Moon is actually forced to flash as High collapses.
Yep. Doesn't have priority in that mid lane for his rise, so Golden Glue has to tells jungler he has to back off. He blows the flash for it instead of risking taking more damage.
Mm-hmm. But that means that gank potential is going to be slightly diminished by that Evelynn. Balls will now escort the minion wave towards Solo's top tier 2 turret. Again, the freeze has been denied.
So, right now, Piglet gonna run down mid lane. But I don't know if he's gonna find anything. He may stealth and like try to look for the victor or something, but it's gonna be a back here for high.
Yeah, Solo's level 6 now. As Moon continues to clear out his side of the jungle, Piglet shows himself.
He was looking for it because that looked like a play where just by the posturing that he had, he wanted to walk down mid, maybe get a Shen ultimate on him because he was hitting 6
mm-hmm.
as he was clearing that top minion wave. And it's that unexpected moment where you're just like...
Yeah.
The first time you see Stan United, it might take you off guard. Second time you see it, you already have like...
You should be prepared.
...had it in your head that, oh yeah, there's a Shen in this game, and he's past 6...
Seems like Cloud9 Challenger rushing
down
mid lane. Exhaust. Gravity Field is not going to proc. However, the Chaos Storm still looks for some additional damage.
All right, and because of all those people in that lane, it's going to tell Moon, hey, bottom lane looks like a great place to go. Evelynn, they can't really do anything about you. They won't see you.
Stunt chasing forward might have given this away.
Submarine.
Cloud9 Challenger. Holding back. There's the submarine. He's spotted out by the turret. Flashed by Lemonation. He sidesteps, but still gets caught by the taunt.
Double.
Stun is going to proc, though, and Lemonation goes down. First blood to Piglet. Teleport going to be completed by Balls. No, he cancels.
It's just the best scenario for TLA because Solo now has global advantage, and then they can do it again. Oh, man. Really well played there from Solo. Got the taunt on two people, the follow-up stun from Stunt, and then Piglet ends up getting first blood. And it's already a way better game for him now than it was last game.
Yeah, Team Liquid Academy now going to pressure down this bottom tier 2 turret. All tech with no culling is going to have a tough time clearing this minion wave. As Piglet firing from the back will drop it.
Yeah, All tech staying around a pretty long time. Yeah, he got caught by that. Would have been a big mistake.
Certainly would have. But Mountain Drake has now spawned in Team Liquid Academy. They take the bottom tier 2 turret. They're actually completing some recalls from Piglet and Stunt. Might have to give up some vision on this side of the map. As Yomu's is picked up along with the Boots of Lucidity for Stunt. More Radiances, more stuns. And right now, Team Liquid Academy are not on the map, but Team Liquid don't know that, and or Cloud9 don't know that, and they cannot take this Mountain Drake quite yet. Team Liquid Academy still have got a lot of vision around that pit.
I love all these wards they have down, but these are super deep wards. You see those wards from TLA that are further down the lane? Like, this is just lit up like a Christmas tree. I wonder where their focus is. I wonder where their TPs are going to go.
Self bottom, tosses out the snare. There goes the spray and pray rat-a-tat as he
chases
down.
Hey, what's up, Altec?
Oh, surprise! Oh, boy.
Surprise!
Yeah. Suddenly Rise.
Surprise.
Exactly.
Yeah, like, that's just a very obvious play coming out there from TLA. Like, I'm very surprised that Cloud9 Challenger did not see this coming from the get-go, because you can't push past that point, and you just have to swap sides of the map or just not push out. They got the advantage already from doing it once. But yeah, against this composition, like, TLA are playing it perfectly. This is really going to put a lot of pressure on Cloud9 Challenger. If this goes to the 5th game, it's really anybody's game.
Mm-hmm.
Because TLA just introduced a completely different strategy that is not completely reliant on just one person. Doubling up, tripling up on stealth, and having the Shen come through, in a way I'm considering that a stealth too. It's the best version of the ninja.
Unexpected ninja. Ooh, nobody saw that golden glue. Just wanted to proc the overload. Here that play is again. And the teleport's been started now.
Yeah, they already went for it. Double TP onto the same ward, and you can't see them unless you have vision. Nearby, it was one of the changes that you can't see teleport in fog unless you have vision of, I believe it's like 700 units away or something like that. I'll have to double check it. But regardless, it's something where they can't see them coming. Have to walk straight into them. It's like, oh!
Whoa, Golden Glue going very aggressive. Eats a lot of damage before the rest of his team collapses.
It's kind of He's trying to outrun the Victor ulti, but it's not happening.
Oh, they're continuing to press forward, though. However,
Piglet, Piglet, the poison!
Oh, gets the kill. 4-0, Team Liquid Academy.
Piglet's angry. Piglet's like, you can't my lane? This is what happens when you can't Piglet's lane and he gets to play another game against you. He's going to turn it around.
Laser gets tossed out. He eats some big damage from Altec. Forced to get a big auto attack back, though. It was a regular-sized auto attack.
Yeah. It's just a Piglet comp, man. You group up and you protect the world champion.
Exactly.
Sometimes he's just going to walk straight into their team, though, and decimate them with Twitch. But at that point, you really have to help him out. It's like Solo didn't even have to blow ultimate there, which puts pressure on Cloud9 Challenger again that another submarine play can come out. It's just awful play against this comp. Like, TLA just... It feels like you can't do anything against them because the possibility that they can do everything against you.
15 and a half minutes in, and Team Liquid Academy have got the run of this game. Piglet's even going to get to catch this huge wave on the bottom side of the map, building towards his rune ends. Meanwhile, Cloud9 Challenger might be looking for a play on that top side of the map. They're starting to prep some vision and escort the minion waves in.
Yeah, because they see Piglet on the bottom side, it's a perfect time for them to actually make a play on the top, knowing that he can't join them. He's going to back, and now we're going to see five members in top side here. High is just going back and forth, figuring out if it's a full roam or not, but they saw him coming.
Moon chases forward, knows now that he's been spotted by a ward. So we'll start to clear out this vision as Cloud9 are forced to back away.
Piglet backed. They can make a play on High in the mid lane. Golden Blue has Flash Root, and High doesn't have a summoner spell for mobility. Whereas I believe Piglet would be able to stealth right into this lane, even deliver solo again. And you have to play around that as Cloud9 Challenger. But it sucks to say that you have to play around that, because that just means you have to play around the possibility of a possibility.
The chance that there could be a stealth Twitch. Moving around.
Pretty sure they saw him, though.
Yeah, doesn't find anyone. However, that Mountain Drake is still up, and with Moon and Stunt helping him and Golden Glue shoving that wave in, they should be able to secure it. This second Drake now for Team Liquid Academy. 17 minutes in, they've only got about a 2,500 gold lead, but with this presence around the map, they've really put Cloud9 in a very uncomfortable position.
And it might just be another one of those games where you talk about it seesawing back and forth, back and forth.
Yeah.
Well, early advantage to TLA.
Will it follow the pattern?
It might. 4-0. Turret up. A lot of potential with the composition they have to continue making plays. If anybody shows up here, they're a goner. So Altec, like a moth to a flame, will be like an AD carry to a minion wave.
He shoves forward, waiting just outside of vision. I think Altec saw.
Altec's doing the same thing. He's just like, oh, God,
don't.
Like, he knows
don't
he can't watch here.
All right, yeah. Piglet finally shows himself, and
I think he's stealthing forward.
Oh, is he?
And now he's showing himself. Yeah, he's moving a little bit faster there on the mini map. When I saw, yeah.
All right, there was a ping. Was they did spot him out now. Finally, yeah.
He was stealthed, and he was like waiting for somebody just in case. He's doing that a lot actually. He's stealthing and then running forward because you have to be able to be in position as they're coming up.
I think Altec is trying to bait this out right now.
It doesn't matter, he's
looks
gonna bait
kill
himself.
Onto Altec. Doesn't quite find it, eats some damage from the culling. Here comes the rest of Cloud9 Challenger. Teleport even being used as well. Piglet has gone too far. They've got vision now. He still gets hit by the knockup. Block zone is gonna soak some of the damage. Piglet turns back onto Altec. He's still alive though. The Cosmic Balls? Radiance keeps him alive. The stun buys time, but Cosmic Radiance resets it completely. And TLA pick up two kills. Make that three, make that four.
And a very unlikely turnaround there for TLA. Piglet looks like he's caught, but nope, everybody to the bottom lane again. Piglet, he's got to be getting revenge for that last game.
Oh, yeah.
Plays really aggressive. Any other AD carry is getting punished in this situation. Walks forward. Altec, you know, takes a few steps too far forward to go back, and then he's like, he wouldn't do it. He wouldn't open on me, but he does. They each get to half HP. And then this is really well played here. Moves up, still eats the knockup, but then perfect Spirit's Refuge there from solo. It stops the application of the Braum stun onto Piglet for the first few autos, so he doesn't get stunned, he doesn't die, the Cosmic Radiance comes down, and honestly, it's just a very well-played fight there from TLA. Great turnaround, and that puts them almost 4,000 gold up.
Yeah.
The way that they're fighting every other game.
Well, they're going to have to upset the trend if they're looking for a game five. So far, they've got the advantage in this game, but Cloud9 Challenger have got the advantage in the series. Team Liquid Academy need to bring us to a game five. They're certainly set up to do it. Three turrets to two, two drakes to zero, and with the next one being an additional mountain drake, they try to submarine down mid lane. Can't quite pull it off. Piglet eats a lot of damage from the culling.
Yeah, it's a rather early time to attempt that play again, especially without the Stand United or the ultimate from Stunt, which was the big turnaround there, or else a bunch of kills would have gone over. They keep their DPS up. And that's the thing about the Cosmic Radiance, is it's just a flat 2.5 second invulnerability for your team. Sure, it has a cast time on it that's 2.5 seconds, but you just pop that thing and you team fight, and then you put pressure on the other team because they wonder, okay, do I kill him? Do I like try to kill him? Do I use all my abilities now? Because he's just going to try to kill me first. And it's not like Lamb's Respite where everybody's invulnerable. It's just the team of Taric.
So far, things have been looking good for Stunt. Golden Glue will find Elimination over the wall. Gets a bit of damage. As he continues to chase it out, Piglet stealths forward. He's looking for it.
Really aggressive again. Solo has Stand United in about 2 seconds here.
Yeah, Ball split pushing on the opposite side of the map. Moon and Solo heading towards the bottom will be forced to pull some of this attention as Piglet will catch that minion wave on the top side. So Team Liquid Academy look for picks, don't quite find them, and get to reset. Cloud9 Challenger still managed to hold on.
And there's always this looming threat that Evelynn is right there. I believe Runan's Hurricane will be completed for Piglet, so as he approaches these fights, he gets that second item, and then his third item, when he ends up getting an Infinity Edge, will be able to decimate these fights, and then you also have a Rise here. So I believe just overall, TLA's comp has so many ways to deal with the scenarios that Cloud9 Challenger would put them in, that it's just a very intelligent draft, taking everybody off guard on the C9C side. Mm-hmm.
Still 22 minutes in. Next Drake is going to spawn in a minute. And Piglet completes his recall and picks up that Runan's Hurricane for himself. 2-0-4 so far. Meanwhile, Golden Glue in the mid lane, fully stacked Rod of Ages, fully stacked Archangels.
Yeah, the Seraphs comes out for him, so he has a little bit of defense now. And then, speaking of defense, Piglet gets a null magic mantle here. So
might be looking for the...
He may go Hex Drinker. We'll see what he ends up doing, but a lot of times you don't want to delay your Infinity Edge. But if he thinks that's the only big threat to him, then it may be worth it, but he will lower his DPS that he would have had at three items.
So low split pushing top as Mountain Drake is 7 seconds from spawning. Balls completing, oh no, canceling his recall, stays on that bottom side. He's got a teleport as well. Very close to that Meganar, but Team Liquid Academy starting off this Mountain Drake immediately, and Cloud9 Challenger nowhere to be found. Means that this is the third Drake of the game going over to TLA.
Absolute control of this game right now. Giving up no neutral objectives and no kills. Just two turrets. That was off of the lane swap. So aside from the lane swap, this is a perfect game for TLA so far.
I'm going to be stealing away the jungle. Red buff given over to the AD carry now. As Piglet drops some trash talk onto that Brambleback.
He was looking a little bit green. Mixed in with some red there.
It's probably because of the plants growing on it.
Ah, that would do it.
But now 24 minutes in, and Team Liquid Academy have got the dragon setup of all dragon setups. That's a third Mountain Drake after that Infernal.
We're having triples today.
Yep.
Go play some poker.
Back to back.
Still, they're just having like great or poor luck here if it's the case of Cloud9 Challenger, because TLA have gotten three Infernals and now an Infernal and three Mountain Drakes, whereas Cloud9 Challenger got three Cloud, where they really would have wanted any of the other three to be triple stacked. would have been great for them. But they didn't end up having that. And TLA end up with a lot of ability to destroy structures. If they get that third one, they can rush a Baron down, especially with this Twitch.
Yeah, Cloud9 Challenger are actually putting on some impressive macro movements right now, but Team Liquid Academy...
Yeah, they're looking for the fight. Team Liquid Academy want to fight. They want to start off fights that you don't see coming.
Ball's now in that bottom lane.
They saw...
putting pressure onto Solo.
They saw Twitch in the Baron pit. He's clearing a ward out there. They also took the sweeper, so... Piglet able to sweep for wards. Know that if he was spotted on his way in to his stealth location.
Ball's actually opening up a pretty big advantage in CS in that top lane.
Oh,
meanwhile, there's the Cosmic Radiant. Stunt goes forward. Teleport now being used by Ball's and Meganar. Solo kites back with Moon, looking for the engage. Moon gets the kill onto Altec, but will fall. Altec on the teleport in. Gets snared and rooted by Golden Glue and killed on top of that. That's 2-for-1 favoring TLA.
And the kill goes over, so no perfect game in that regard to TLA. But they end up getting more kills in response. They start getting this mid turret. Might push for two here because that's the AD carry down. And that's also the Victor laser down too. So they're going to start getting some damage on this. They're going to use the Twitch stealth for some attack speed.
Ooh, Spears. Oh, Contracts goes in and flash for Piglet. Dodges the pounce. He's still able to get one kill onto Stunt, but the tier two stays standing.
Still blows a summoner spell for Stunt. Ends up getting the summoner spell from Piglet, which may pay off later because if you are able to take out the Twitch in a team fight, oh, you still have a Ryze to deal with, but it's going to help you out a bunch.
And Team Liquid Academy find the flank they're looking for.
This is a very strange fight here because they get Piglet to half HP. He has to pop the ultimate. Lemonation's doing a great job in the front of having the Unbreakable up, but then Moon goes for Altec, gets him just barely too, but is incredibly aggressive, trades his life for it, but he got rid of the AD carry. So that was mission accomplished there for Moon. By pretty much all measures of how you want to play Evelynn. Mm-hmm.
27 minutes in, 6,000 gold lead, 5.5 if you want to get technical, for Team Liquid Academy. With that next Mountain Drake spawning and a very strong Twitch and an even stronger Ryze, they are looking poised to take this game and bring us to a game 5, but things have slowed down a bit after that early action that we've had. And in fact, Cloud9 Challenger were the ones to start off that last fight, despite Team Liquid Academy being the ones looking for the play themselves.
Yeah, they were trying to catch Piglet out, and both teams understand from what we've been seeing in their matches that they're proactive. Both teams are being very proactive. And it seems to be the first team to really get a lead will run away with the game because they just continue to make very aggressive plays. They know how to play from ahead and abuse a lead. Speaking of abusing a lead, here comes TLA solo.
There goes the submarine. Altec dashes into his team, but that's a three-man taunt for Team Liquid Academy. They pick up two kills, and Lemonation will fall to Moon. A double kill. They're in front of the Baron pit.
Yep, time to do the Baron for TLA. They want to bring it to a game 5, and they want to get this gigantic serpent down so that they can start getting even more structures. And with the double Mountain Drake, it's just so easy to do.
Yeah. That Baron falls. Team Liquid Academy race down towards the mid lane to try to catch up and keep this Tier 1 standing. They do not succeed as Cloud9 get that small consolation prize. But Team Liquid Academy now have got complete control of this game.
Absolute control. Shen ultimate goes off now. Can't see it channeling. And then all of a sudden, Moon, out of nowhere, gets a triple taunt. And also it would have been 4, but High flashes over him. So High ends up making it away. But it's still 3 members go down there off of that play. And you think you're safe because you're in the middle of your lane, but it's just really Evelynn was hugging the wall.
Ooh, that's the tank.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh. They're just waiting there for now.
Yeah, if we stay here long enough, eventually we'll have a good position on the Mountain Drake and we'll flank them. And no, that's not what's happening because they have Baron buff. They're going to go straight for these towers.
TLA rush right down mid. They don't need that third Mountain Drake just yet because they've already secured the big neutral objective. Bottom lane is pushing in their favor, and now they've got pressure in the other two lanes in mid and top. Golden Glue races forward. That auto attack Lemonation is going to be the one who's forced to defend it with that Unbreakable. However, Diglett's already dropped the other tier two.
Yep. Goes down very quickly. Looks like he went for the Hex Drinker, and then he's going into the Longsword. Or sorry, he had a Longsword. I believe he sold it.
Stun eats a lot of damage. Lemonation tries to tag him. There goes the Cosmic Radiance used on himself to keep alive.
Yeah, to dissuade them from continuing to fight or engaging there with balls, like possibly hopping in, flashing, or anything along those lines. But that's going to give some time for Cloud Knight Challenger with a brief respite here.
Ooh, Spear Toss by Contracts, looking to chase Golden Glue away. Altec in the bottom lane. Uses Yomu's to clear this wave out, but looks like TLA are going to settle for that now.
So we talked about how last game, TLA's bottom lane at one point was a combined 0-9. Well, Cloud Knight Challenger's bot lane. I wonder where the action and the focus has been this game. It's that bottom lane. It looked like an obvious strategy from the get-go, but TLA are able to still execute on it way better than Cloud9 Challenger were even expecting it to be. And that puts that lane at 0-9, and Altec can't even like sit around here. He's like, the dragon died. That means Twitch can be at least two screens away, which means run.
Play it safe.
Yeah.
We have the late game.
I mean, the ability to avoid vision, avoid the wards unless they're pink, is something that can't be overstated here. Just Moon gets to walk past minions. You have mental routes in your head of where somebody can be because you have vision control of like three choke points. You're like, there's no way he's past here, etc. But it's like, no, Evelyn can be there. And if it's Moon, he is there.
Yeah, 4-1-6 this game. 10 kill participation for everyone except for Solo, who's turned it up to 11. With that triple Mountain Drake and Baron buff still for about 15, 20 more seconds, Team Liquid Academy starting to try to split push.
Piglet working towards the Maw, and yeah, they're trying to split push, but their strategy is just best when they're grouping up and it's unexpected. So this gives them a little bit of an edge here when they're split, because it looks like it's just one person or two people, but it could really be three or four very quickly.
Ooh, Solo gets some good damage. Golden Glue or goes two. In. Flash Nair. Golden Glue's the target. Exhaust. There's the Stand United. Solo gets canceled out of it as he turns in for the taunt. Here comes Moon. Flash is used. Lemonation chases. Are they going to be able to pick up the kills? Piglet's dissuaded. Moon in the front goes low. And is it going to escape? Meanwhile, Piglet has opened up on the side. Not able to find any kills, though, as the minion wave gets cleared out by High.
Yep. No kills go over to either side. It's just the minion wave gets shoved up. And it looked like Solo actually got the best scenario there. Levy ultied onto Golden Glue, and then he got interrupted, so he was immediately able to taunt out of it. Because you don't really want to teleport at that point, you just want control of your champion back.
Yeah. Shield the carry, and then fight.
Yep. Normally you have to keep going, but nope. Ends up getting interrupted and able to taunt through.
Yeah. Unfortunately, Solo does not complete charging his Kamehameha.
I actually think it's fortunate there. Very fortunate.
It's 33 minutes in. Team Liquid Academy still very comfortable lead in this game, but now they've got the most difficult task ahead of them, breaking the inhibitor line.
I mean, with Triple Mountain Drake,
well, sure,
it's a little bit easier, especially since you have all of this pressure. Like, your stealth champions can just show up in a lane that has less defenders on it when you're split pushing, and then you just show up with Twitch. Maybe he even pops ultimate because he'll outrange turrets and blows them up. But they still have to get minion waves to that point. Teleports are both up for the solo laners here, and Piglet's playing it pretty far back.
Yeah, taking his time. 90 seconds for that Baron to respawn, and now Team Liquid start to set up their side lanes. However, Cloud9 Challenger aggress into the mid lane. Might be looking for an opportunistic pick, but Team Liquid Academy not going to give them the luxury. Just trying to dodge that vision, oof, keep themselves safe. Moon,
he just avoided all the pink wards in the jungle.
Giving it the old Jaws theme, hunting from behind. Cloud9 Challenger back away. Is he going to go in?
Oh. No. You'll know he's going in when you see the Shen ultimate go on cooldown. Where was he? And he gets disappeared.
He gets disappeared. Yes. He avoids the vision. Will be spotted out by Altec, though. Piglet sneaks forward. There's the submarine. This is the time that they're trying to go in. Cosmic Radiance on Piglet is going to keep him alive. That buys a lot of time, and the disengage is not enough. They manage to kill Balls. High continues to chase. Laser on the stunt. Piglet stealthing back in. Looking for High. Oh, but does not find enough.
Yeah, doesn't get that extra kill on top of it. Baron up in 17, 15 seconds now. And they keep fishing for these kills. They killed off Balls. Balls... he'll be up about 20 seconds into the Baron, so I feel like it'll go down faster than that if TLA just get on it.
Yeah.
But they don't have some of those crucial ultimates for this team fight.
Taking a look at Cloud9 Challenger's vision, it is severely limited. Triple Mountain Drake, and they are going to try to burn through. They decide to go for the fight instead as Piglet gets caught. He goes low. There goes the Hex Drinker, able to keep him alive. And Contrax leaps forward. Altec races in, trying to trade his life. He succeeds. However, that's going to be four kills for Team Liquid Academy.
And only High remains. Very low HP, very low mana. Here comes Balls with the TP. Doesn't have an R bar, though. They're going to try to go for broke here. What's he got?
TLA now pushing onto the Baron, trying to drop it. Instead, they turn for Balls. He leaps away, solo in the front. Baron secured, Smite secure. And Team Liquid Academy on four members. They've got that Baron buff, taking the extended trade.
I don't know why Piglet's off on this right side as well. It's just really random because he's by himself. Gets exhausted, has to flash, doesn't have ultimate either at this point, so it's really just that Twitch basic attack range. And there wasn't really vision of the pit either. And, oh man, he almost makes it into the bush. And I feel as though if he had made it into the bush, maybe he would have dropped vision for like enough of a second there that Altec would end up attacking the wrong target and wasting an auto. But
the skill
he was going for it.
Yeah, the skill of the previous world champion in season 3 definitely on show here, as now with the Baron buff, Team Liquid Academy going to have to eventually start breaking down these inhibitors. They've had an advantage from the get-go, from the very early game, but they have had a very difficult time converting it beyond those barons, beyond those dragons. You still gotta drop the Nexus guys. Cloud9 Challenger are starting to get just a bit big. High completing a lot of items. Altec getting pretty big as well. You saw what he could do if he found that Twitch undefended.
Yeah, you have to... still consider the power of Cloud9 Challenger, but this Elder Dragon.
They don't have Vision of the Ward.
Yeah, all that
Golden Blue damage. Looking for Contracts, doesn't find him. But Elder Dragon is secured. Aspect of the Dragon now on Team Liquid Academy for 2 minutes, along with that Baron buff.
And this is, once again, a very bad game for Anidalee, because... Oh, I mean, what's she going to do here? It was first pick, too. And that's what I want to start talking about here is with this 10K gold advantage for TLA, you might have to start thinking about game 5 right now as Cloud9 Challenger. The first pick, Nidalee, and then you gave over Shen and what turned out to be a contested pick in Twitch.
Mm-hmm.
Next game, you either have to ban one of those or you take it first. If you take Twitch first, you probably get countered and they take Shen. But if you take Shen first, well... then they get Nidalee? What?
I
feel like that's
not a very interesting
good.
Trade.
We'll
Golden
see.
Blue goes forward. There goes the Cosmic Radiance. They're trying to dive this moon. Guardian Angel gets popped, but Team Liquid Academy rush forward after having dropped Lemonation and take down that inhibitor finally. They continue to press forward, though. They could be trying to end the game right here.
Oh, yeah,
there goes the flash there onto Altec. He is dead. It's up to Contracts, High, and Balls to keep that Nexus standing. But they do not stand a chance. Team Liquid Academy, even it up, and we are going to game 5.
Series is going the distance here, 2-2. Ready for that final game in the Challenger Series Finals. Competing to get into the double elimination portion of the promotion tournament and to be the champions.
Oh man, and this series is delivering. Every time these teams play, it is back and forth and back and forth. Currently, it is 3-3 between TLA and Cloud9 Challenger.
Yeah, that's overall record
yeah.
in Challenger Series, this split. of course, because they played earlier on in the split week one, and they went 1-1. And that's just how evenly matched these two teams are. And it's just going back and forth. And they aren't even swapping sides. Like, that's the very interesting thing here as well, is it's blue every game for Cloud9 Challenger and red every game for TLA. So it's not the whole, oh, whoever gets blue side is just winning the match, or whoever gets red side. It's like, no, no, no. They are just swapping strategies every time. And it's like, okay, you did this, we're going to do this again.
Yeah.
And then they just change it. And every time they just get the leg up. So coming into this fifth game, you have to kind of head off your opponent at the curve and think about what they want to do, what their best strategy is, what they're most confident in. Because for TLA, that looked really good and looked like Cloud9 Challenger, even with the shot calling that they have that we continue to praise and like highs and stuff like that. They still didn't seem capable of actually dealing with this comp early on. And a lot of the scenarios where you have to think this is exactly what the Evelynn would want to do or the Twitch would want to do, they didn't avoid.
Yeah, very confident play from Moon. But for more on that series tying win, we're going to hand it off to Dash, Crumbs, and Freak.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Game five, as he mentioned, 3-3 over the season. These teams are locked dead in a tie. We've got one game left to figure it out. But Team Liquid Academy giving us that equalizer in this game. I kind of want to break down the win, how they got there. Looking at champion select, a whole lot of stuff shifted around this time, right? We see Team Liquid picking up that Shen for the first time, which means that Balls is forced off of it. We see him on the Gnar. But more importantly, the thing that jumps to me is Evelynn. Simply because we haven't seen it in the LCS. Now, Moon is no stranger to that. I know he's played it before, but Evelynn always changes the dynamic of a League of Legends
game.
It's
a double submarine composition.
Yep. The double submarine.
And yeah, you can go about how much you love that one.
Okay, so I love when teams do things like what TLA did here.
Okay.
They've basically invented a comp that they've practiced that works for them. It's double stealth, double buddy CC, right? Evelynn or Twitch comes in, Shen on top. Evelynn or Twitch comes in with a Taric stun coming through from the invisibility. Like, this is so sick, and I love it. And they made sure they paired it with a good immediate TPing mid laner as well. Ryze can show up and immediately part of this. So TLA is always, at any time, incredibly surprising.
Yes.
If you've not played against this composition, you will be surprised. You will get effed up. And it happened many times. And I love when teams invent comps like this.
All right, so they've invented the composition. I'm going to challenge you now as the representative of Cloud9 Challenger, Crumbs, to figure out how to dismantle this team comp. Since you haven't had too much ability to practice against it, you know, since Team Liquid's the only team that's running this type of composition, where do you start?
Well, I personally am a heavy advocate for the Ryze at all times, so I practically think that Ryze is just a ridiculous pick that should never be overlooked. But the thing is that because Cloud9 is just so telegraphed in the draft, you know exactly what they're always going for, particularly with the support pool. It's either Karma, Braum, or Nami. If Karma's up, it's Karma. If Braum is up, then it's Braum. And Taric against Braum is such a good matchup, so you're already guaranteeing that whatever composition TLA is in the draft is going to have that Taric, and Taric with Ryze is insane. You do not want to give Ryze invulnerability and a long-range stun, as well as with these with the submarine effect. But the thing that I'm looking at the most at is that in the pregame, we talked about how Cloud9 is a team that usually relies and was able to get by in the Challenger series by having really strong solo laners, veteran status, the contracts as a jungler is a relatively new player with, you know, he's used to that carry style. But the thing is that if you're not going to be able to pressure lanes, you're not going to be able to actually make it into the bigger leagues. And TLA is a team that's looking to make it into the big leagues, so they're obviously better than the competition that was before.
Yeah.
And they've gotten crushed every time that they pick no ganking junglers. The Graves and the Nidalee just get smoked out of the water, whereas the Rex and the Gragas have so much effect onto these games. So for the next game, whichever team can get a hold of the stronger pressure matchup, I think is going to have a massive edge.
Right, and Nidalee just didn't simply pressure enough for Moon to be forced, you know, to react on the Evelynn.
And the thing is, I feel like a champion like Nidalee can work. Like, Nidalee, we know, is a champion who will just live in the enemy jungle and prevent you from doing anything. That didn't happen, though. Nidalee's supposed to smash the jungle for a matchup, push Evelynn around.
The Evelynn is a counter matchup for that one.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Okay, so
well,
you're
better than me at that. Well, you got to find Evelynn in order to go harass her, right?
Yeah. So, and like, you actually are never going to hit a long-range spear on Evelynn as well, so you're always going to be basically up close, and Evelynn's going to win it every time.
So you actually stop Nidalee at the game she's supposed to do against the junglers. I'm actually surprised we don't see more pros pick up Evelynn, because Nidalee's not a stranger to
Evelynn.
Well,
but that's the thing, right? If it's a counter matchup, it works, like, learn the champion.
Yeah.
Evelynn's very squishy as a champion. Sure, she can't get popped. But hey, look, we're finding that there may be a place for her in very specific metas and matchups.
Sure.
Moving on, though, let's look at some replays, because I do want to take a moment to break down or look towards game five. Before we do so, 13 minutes into the game, 2-0, 14 Liquid Academy in the bot lane here, starting off with the Twitch stealth.
Well, wonderful stuff. Of course, a nice block elimination. But the thing is, the teleports are already coming in from behind. So TLA are very reliably getting into these plays. And where's the rest of C9C? Well, they're nowhere to be seen. No one's here at all to help them out. The teleport came in from the Ryze. The teleport came in from the Shen. And, well, there's an easy double kill. And these kind of things kept happening. Things like these TPs were never matched. They were never punished for the teleports out. You just lost a dual lane and no turrets fell as a result.
Well, it's just one of those situations where I feel like on Cloud9 Challenger, I'd be overly comfortable for the entire game because you don't see Evelynn. You shouldn't be comfortable.
Oh, sure.
My point is that like you're not feeling pressure because half the time you don't see Twitch and half the time you don't see Evelynn, and a lot of people out of sight, out of mind. Of course, it's exactly the opposite. You need to be expecting that Twitch to show up or an Evelynn behind. And of course, we've got Shen global pressure, Ryze with teleport. They just didn't seem to be aware of the fact that they could always be pressured. There's always the chance of a 4v2 at any point in the game.
And against a composition like that, usually the answer is to just lane swap all the time. You just want to be avoiding any sort of confrontation the entire game. Just make it a purely macro sense, and you never get surprised by any flanks, because that's really the key of the Shen with the stealth. You outnumber the opponent, similar to just a regular Shen composition, just a little bit of the stealth factor. But that just didn't happen. And one of the things that I think held them back is the fact that Hai was losing that mid lane rather early on. And there was a big CS discrepancy in the duo lane that just put the lanes in such a deficit just from the start. Maybe they were worried about the Evelynn ganking them, because obviously Taric can be a very surprising gank.
Right.
Surprise, you get stunned from the brush, you're dead.
Yeah, right? Exactly. Next up, 1830 into the game, 4-0 for Team Liquid Academy. This is also in the bot lane. Once again, Piglet with the stealth.
Yeah, and it looks so greedy from Piglet, too. Like, he actually misses his W, trades with Altec, but then you feel like CNNC's actually collapsing first. The Braum is there first. He actually does a bad job putting a ward down. Balls is already TPing to the wrong ward, so he's actually late to the party here on this Gnar. But basically, Piglet lives long enough. There's the dodge zone as well, and it turns out the rest of TLA was actually already collapsing. Right, you actually have Hai showing up late to the party. A beautiful ulti comes out from Taric that actually blocks all of Hai's CC. And the thing is, Hai has a 2.5 second window to know they're turning invulnerable. He just shouldn't be pressing E and R at that point.
Wait.
It sucks, but
you gotta wait.
He does not play against enough Taric. And Hai is a great player. He's been playing League forever, but guess what? Taric rework happened this year.
Welcome to the gem zone.
Right, welcome to the gem zone. And this is part of why I think bringing out new champions can work well. You've got an all-star player like Hai who didn't count to 2.5 seconds. Like, this is one of the best players in North America.
And it's not because he can't count to 2.5 seconds.
I'm pretty sure he can count to 2.5 seconds.
I am fairly certain that he knows how to count to 2.5 seconds. It's because he doesn't have the practice against that champion.
And this is just a silly thing. Like, maybe it's nerves, maybe it's who knows what, but like, that's a mistake you should just not make as a pro player. Mm-hmm. Some of that could be unfamiliarity. Some of that could be being into game 4. I don't know what it is, but like, here you go. Part of this is bringing out a new thing that people aren't scrimming against very frequently.
All right, so we're 2-2.
Yep.
Next game, all the marbles, essentially a best of one, right? From what we've seen tonight, I want from you guys the game plan for these teams moving into game 5. This is their ticket to the promotion tournament to get into the LCS. What do they come out here with?
So when you go into a best of 5 and you come down to that final game, you usually have to soak in everything that's worked in the first couple of games and put that into a culmination of, all right, what do we do for this final draft? And I think for Cloud9, they should most likely be looking at that Rek'Sai as their first rotation.
Mm-hmm.
And to be honest, you throw out the meta out the window. You don't really care what the world meta looks like at that point. You just care what the meta is within that series. And within the series, Twitch is huge.
Okay.
It's been banned the entire series, and Twitch just obliterated the bottom lane. It had such a strong showing, and I think it's a bigger priority than the Shen. While the Shen did work for Cloud9, and I think that it might be seen as the reason of the success, because maybe you feel uncomfortable making a play with the possibility of the Shen ultimate as a counter.
Mm-hmm.
I think that the Twitch is ultimately a bigger deal because he also scales so massively into the late game, has great pick potential, and Altec and Piglet are no slouches on the carry potential.
Final thoughts?
I agree with you. CC jungler, Rek'Sai, then Gragas, then at least if you have to, something with early pressure. The early game has been the big deal so far this series, getting lanes ahead, and it feels like these teams just snowball when they get ahead. So find your lane matchups, find your jungler, snowball the first 10 minutes.
All right, we're looking for these teams to come out strong and aggressive, get those leads, and take it all home. The series is all tied up, and the team that takes the next game will be claiming the title of Challenger Champions. Meet us back here in a few minutes for the conclusion of Cloud9 Challenger versus Team Liquid Academy.
Cloud9 Challenger, if they're able to take convincing wins like they did in game number 1 and game number 3, they're definitely going to be looking to do it once again.
Twitch, come towards me.
Yep, no, I'm going to Twitch. I'll save you. Watch out for our flash.
I exhausted it.
Kill Gnar. Go Victor after.
Victor.
Altec dashes into his team, but that's a 3-man taunt
for Team Liquid Academy. They pick up two kills.
I'm going. I'm on Nidalee. I'm on Victor.
I have top flash in 2 seconds.
I'm on Victor.
Lucian flashed in. I got the bomb. Kill bomb.
Gold Eagle goes forward. There goes the Cosmic Radiance. They're trying to dive this moon. Guardian Angel gets popped. Team Liquid Academy, even it up, and we are.